centuries in a cave up north. You might be wondering if this cave was in, like, Finland or Iceland or Siberia. And that's not important, but I'll tell you, it was farther north than you'd ever imagine anyone living. I am a son of Flexnaprov. Yes, it sounds like one of those new arthritis or osteoporosis or osteoarthritis drugs, but it's actually totally original, and really, how could he have known about the future of the drug market way back in the 70s when he named me? Yes, he named me, because I don't have a mother. Patients are generally hermaphrodites. I am not a hermaphrodite. I am, however, polysexual, polymorphous, and polyamorous, meaning I can have sex with a number of people and love them all for their many differences, while I myself am turning into other people. Sometimes my partner of the moment looks up or back or to the side or under his or her blindfold and doesn't recognize me halfway through intercourse. And I know this sounds like a lie, but it never scares anyone away. In fact, I've had my fair share of stalkers, anonymous letters sealed in pink envelopes smeared with perfume, and strangers offering to buy me dinner after midnight. This is always good because, being a wizard's son, I don't have a quote-unquote job. Neither did Molotov, and I suspect that was why he lived in a cave all these years and never had sex with anyone but himself. I say it like that, but self-love is not really that funny or strange like everyone pretends it is. I practice self-love up to 5 times a day, as a rule. It is as important as any aspect of grooming or hygiene, and more so than stale traditions such as manners and etiquette. I also practice an operant offshoot of Buddhism called Hooism, wherein I try to cure all the world's pain through self-love, polyamory, and a vision of many dueling perspectives coming together in perfect harmony on my living room sofa. Warren G. is one of Cubism's many monks, though I am just a follower. Former President Bill Clinton is also affiliated with the religion somehow. I didn't know I was in any way like my father until after he was killed in 1984. It was your typical auto de fe, the way wizards, witches, spinsters, drunkards, adulterers, and other social deviants have been disposed of since the early days of the Dark Ages. A local mob, maybe they were Scandinavian, maybe not, heard him making noise up in his cave dwelling and took him down for questioning. He wouldn't answer them, he didn't even speak their language, but he kept shooting black dust out of his wand, which, when he was nervous, was about all he could muster of his great powers. The dust made one of the babies in the hall sneeze and cry, and that was it for my poor father. He was dragged out to the village square and stoned to death. I wonder if that little baby grew up knowing she was indirectly responsible for my father's death. Anyway, it happened when I was 14, when I'd been traveling for a while in Nepal, and when I came home, I found the cave empty, but for a note stuck to the icy wall with a sword. Dear son, it said, please take care of Lefty. When I heard through the grapevine what had happened, it not being widely known in the village that the wizard had a son, I wondered how on earth he had managed to leave me that note. Then again, he was magic, which explained pretty much all the inexplicable things I'd ever wondered about him, except for why I was a magic too. Lefty was my father's pet snake, who veered perpetually to the left and went round and round in circles whenever you picked him up out of his glass bowl habitat and put him on the floor. When I had nothing left to do in town, I gathered him up, put him in my knapsack, and left the cave, never to return. Since then, I've found out more about myself than I ever would have as a hopeless apprentice, a fate I would have been doomed to fulfill as a son of a living wizard. I moved to LA, into an apartment with a woman who created the Divine Master, although I will not say her name out of respect for the dead. Then we went our separate ways, and I had a string of faceless lovers, all of whom let me bump with them for a time. I started finding out I was magic in these little ways, like smiling to get a free cup of coffee, or brushing my hair one morning before going out and getting practically abducted by a modeling scout. Also, I've been doing these little dances for Lefty, turning on his favorite salsa music, this one Tito Puente song he goes crazy for, and now he turns to the right. Tragedy, my father didn't live to see this because he thought his way was the only way. He'd been working on a Lefty righty spell for years, but his abilities were really bottoming out after his 300-year tenure on Earth, hence the nervous lawn dust. And sometime after I fixed Lefty, I realized that this was what my father wanted all along, a wizard's son. But it was many more years before my religion let me adopt that